What's up, everybody? So today, it's gonna get steep, it's gonna get loose, and we're on an XC bike, so it could get pretty wild. But we're not going down, no, we're gonna be going up. Yes, we're gonna be looking at some common XC climbing mistakes and how to fix them. So sit back, relax, and let's dive on in. Right, before we get any further into this video, why not show the channel a little bit of love by clicking the subscribe button and also the bell as well, so you'll get great notifications every time a video comes out. Right then, here's the first one, and it is keeping enough weight over the front. I often see people riding and their weight isn't far enough forward on an XC bike, especially up really steep climbs. Though what's happening is the front end's going very lightweight, which is making steering and maneuvering around quite tricky, or they're actually just looping out. I've seen people properly just loop out before as well. This is a common mistake and one that I reckon we definitely can remedy. So to combat this then, the obvious answer is get more weight over the front. But how do we do that? Well, it's not quite as easy as it sounds. What I'll actually do is I'll slide my butt back in the saddle a little bit more, but rotate my hips, allowing me to get my body further forwards and lowering myself down with my arms. So actually, what that does is shifts a little weight back, bear with me, so that there's still traction going through the rear wheel, so you've still got the grip, but it's enabling me to then lean forwards a little bit more as well, putting more of my upper body weight over the front to keep the front end down. So do remember, obviously, like I said, when you've got that saddle up and you're hunched over like that, you still want to be looking ahead, which we're going to get to, but make sure you are still looking where you're going rather than having your head down. It's very easy to get into that trap of just sort of power down. Make sure you're still looking 2 to 3 meters ahead. The speeds are slower going uphill, obviously, so you don't need to be looking miles ahead, but just enough to be able to make sure you're doing the right thing. Right, let's talk a little bit about sort of saddle height and setup now, because it makes a massive difference in cross country having this area here set up just right. So with your saddle height, when the dropper is all the way up, if you're running a dropper, you want to have an ever such slight bend in your knee when it's at full extension. So when that crank is at the bottom and you're sitting down with the seat is at its highest point, there should still be an ever such slight bend in your knee. If it's too high and your knee's locking out when you're at maximum extension, when you're at your furthest point on the pedal stroke, well then that is going to cause you some discomfort. You're also not actually able to push all the way around on the pedal stroke. Same if it's too low. If that seat's too low and your knee's not extending enough, you're actually putting more pressure on your knees to try and push as hard as you can down on the pedals as well. When it comes to saddle angle, well, this one is a personal preference, but having it incorrectly set up is going to give you pain where, let's just face it, you don't want no pain. If the front of the saddle is too low, you might find yourself slipping off the front of the saddle. Likewise, if the nose of the saddle is pointing up ever too much, well then you're going to put pressure in places that pressure should not be put, and because of that you're actually going to find it harder to pedal and ride over a long distance of time, especially when you're climbing, because if that saddle's pointing too high up at the front when you're shifting all that weight forwards, let's just say it this way, you're shifting all that weight onto something that should not be weighted. Now, it's a bit of a myth in the XC world that rock hard tires or higher tire pressures are better. They're faster, less rolling resistance, less drag, things like that. Actually, times have changed. XC tires have got a lot better over the years. Now, whilst that might have been true, like I said, in the past, because of improved things like casing, compound, width, rock hard tire pressures aren't really the done thing anymore. And on a climb especially, they're gonna lose you traction. So if you find yourself powering up a climb and your wheel's spinning away, you're not really getting the grip, especially if it's on something quite loose or perhaps it's quite wet and rooty, rocky terrain, and that's not really biting into the ground, well then probably your tires are a little bit too firm. If you've got a pressure gauge, especially a digital one like this Topeak one here, that's a really useful tool to actually just trial and error getting the right pressures. What I'd recommend is do a run. If it's spinning, maybe drop it ever so slightly and just incrementally play with it until you find the perfect pressure. Now, having said that, there is too low a pressure. You will find that if you start to drop the pressures too low, sort of maybe 15 PSI or under perhaps, that you are actually going to expose yourself to the risk of getting more punctures. And actually, that whole drag theory and it just bouncing up and down, especially on a hardtail, is going to come into play. So there is sort of an optimal range. If you want to know, for me personally, I run my rear tire at about 23 to 25 PSI. Look at this horrible climb then. I'm gonna come up this in a second. And you can see it's absolutely littered with rocks all over the place of all different sizes. So picking out the right line is what's crucial next when it comes to climbing on an XC bike, because you haven't got those big old Enduro tires and that extra travel to just plow over everything. You've got to be a little bit more precise and a bit more careful with where you're going to head up. So we're gonna go up this, we're gonna take a look at the line I take and exactly why I take it. Okay then, so on a climb like this, I'm gonna use the path of least resistance. So I'm gonna aim to avoid all the big rocks, because if I hit and start going over those, I'm gonna lose traction and I'm gonna slow me down and just make my life a lot more difficult. So I'm gonna skirt around all the big ones and hopefully just keep on going to the top. We'll go up around this way, up on this smoother bit here. See you in a bit. Now remember to obviously always be looking ahead and adapting that line when you do get to it. Things might have moved. If you're racing, well there I would suggest, this is my best tip, never follow. Because if you're following someone up a tricky climb and they mess up, well then you've got nowhere to go. If you can go on a different line, then you're gonna be able to easily overtake and see ya. Right, my next top tip is cadence when it comes to crushing those climbs. So when it comes to cadence, you'll see a lot of people pushing a really hard gear, and we'll get onto gearing shortly, but they'll be putting out like 75, maybe 80 RPM. Really hard work. Now you want to be spinning circles, not pistons. So what I mean by that is basically instead of just pushing down really hard, you want to be spinning real nice, smooth circles. So nice and smooth on the whole way around the stroke. Both sides of your legs, obviously, not just pushing then and then letting the other one just trail behind. A smoother, higher cadence is going to be a lot more efficient and less energy zapping on the way up the hill. So next time you're giving it a go, try just putting it in one gear easier, spinning that little bit quicker, but actually you'll find that it's much more efficient. You'll be able to climb quicker, longer, faster, and leave the opposition behind you. Right then, this next XC climbing conundrum is all about gear changing. So being in the right gear at the right time and changing gear at the right time as well. It sounds simple, right? It's not quite as simple as it sounds. Okay, so when it comes to changing gear on the climb, smoothness is key, like I've said. You want to aim to be shifting maybe one, two gears at a time. More often than not, I'll see people just grabbing a big handful and trying to shift it two, three, four at a time, and it is making horrendous noises. It's not good for your drivetrain and it's gonna actually slow you down. Try to back off the power ever so slightly and slot it into gear nice and evenly. That way you can keep the cadence and the power consistent and so keep on climbing at a nice smooth rate. Another great top tip is getting the right gear at the base of the climb. So if you're coming into a climb, don't come into that, like I said, in like ninth gear and then just try and smash it through all the gears. Preempt what gear you're going to need. So you can be like, right, it's fairly steep. I'll shift up a couple. Now the cadence might be a little bit quicker at the base or as soon as you start that climb, but it'll soon even out once you get going. Anyway, we're at the end of the video. It's freezing, but we've made it, people. Look, as always, a little subscribe to the channel goes a long way to showing some love. Click the bell as well if you want the notifications. I'm out of here because I'm gonna go get me a nice cup of tea because it's Baltic, but for me, for now, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you later.